your hand holding me. How could I live without you? I could not see. Lord, what would I do in life and where would I go? Oh my, how would I handle things? All that I know.
Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall forever live and believe in me shall never die.
Mm-hmm.
Do you believe
it?
For I know that my Redeemer lives. And at last, he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been thus destroyed, then from my flesh I shall see God, who I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. My heart faints within me, for we brought nothing into this world, and we cannot take anything out of the world. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
At this time of our celebration of life and legacy, of our mother, our sister, our grandmother, our aunt, cousin, and our closest friend, of our very beloved Miss Frances Mae Johnson Jones, also known to many as Sister Jones, mm-hmm. Sister Frances, and to the preachment of this land, Exhorter Jones. We want to take this time to let the family know Sister Bonnie, Sister Avis, Sister Marion, Sister Loretta, Sister Dot, Sister Mary, Brother Charlie, Brother Marvin, amen. To all the grands, to the great grands, amen. To all the family, amen. We know that our gentle words, amen, cannot bring back the loss of the loved one. But we know, we hope that our words will give you comfort and peace and strengthen you in the days ahead. May the memories continue to be cherished, and that they're not lived, that they're not long gone, but they will live forever. At this time, we will go ahead and move on in our order of service. We will have our prayer of solace by Elder Mary Jackson, and then we will have our scripture reading by Dr. Reverend Patrice Fields. Then we will have our special family tribute by Sister Sonia Nikki Dalton, and then we will have a special selection of Heaven is a Beautiful Place by Brother Glenn Neal, and then we will have our words of comfort. Amen.
Amen.
In that order. Amen.
just wanted to encourage the family. Of course, you know, the Lord is good and we give him all the glory.
Mm-hmm.
In spite, we thank God for our loved ones and we celebrate their life. That's mm-hmm. what we do. And certainly, I want to encourage you and let you know that the Lord is with you and we love you very much. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting Father, the creator of all mankind, we stand to tell you thank you, for you said in all things we ought to give you thanks. And so Lord, we thank you first of all for being our God, for being our Savior, for being our Redeemer, for being the God that have showed us mercy down through the years. And we say thank you Lord, for the life of our dear sister whom we had a chance to fellowship with so many times.
Yes,
Lord, we thank you for this family whom we've had the opportunity to get to know to some degree. Mm-hmm. And we thank you for their lives. Thank you for their kindness. Mm-hmm. And so, God, we pray that as they continue to lift each other's arms up, that they would develop strength, even the greater, among each other, Master. And more than anything, God, we thank you for you said, I go to prepare a place for you.
Yes, Lord.
Go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I'm coming again to receive you
by myself. Yes, Lord.
And thank you for that better place, place where there will be no more sorrow.
Yes.
There will be no more crying. There will be no more dying.
Yes.
We will be with you forever. So, Master, we thank you. Continue
thank
to bless
you.
Us as we share with each other, as we continue to be role models, mentors, and the people of God that we ought to be.
Yes.
Again, we say, bless the family.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you.
Good morning, beloved.
Good morning. Good morning.
We honor the Lord for this opportunity to share with not only this family, but with family that is part of my family.
Mm-hmm.
I give honor to Pastor Wright, to Elder Jackson, to other clergy that may be assembled. I bring you greetings from my mom and from my youngest sister, who she just fell in love with Sister Frances.
Amen.
When I told her of Sister Frances' transition, she was just overcome. I met Sister Frances on the very first day of my pastorate at Bethel. She came in to help me row. And there was something about her that I asked her. I said, have you been called to preach? She looked at me. She smiled. Her eyes began to fill with tears. I said, we good. We good. And she was such a blessing to me throughout those 5 years. And I just want to thank you, Johnson and Jones and Neil and Stingle families, for having embraced me and made me feel like family. And I did get to see her before she went home to be with the Lord. The first thing I noticed was that Mrs. Issue was aging backwards. And I said, she's just getting ready to go home because there is no aging in heaven. So we thank God for her beautiful life and we thank God for receiving her home. And we thank God that in his word, he comforts us in moments like this. From Psalm 46, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. There is a river. There is a river, the streams whereof shall be glad, the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. Come behold the works of the Lord, what desolations he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still, be still, be still, be still, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. the God of Jacob is our refuge. Beloved, we have a hiding place. And from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 in the New Testament, beginning at verse 13 and following. But I would not have you ignorant, my brothers and my sisters, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout and with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the air to meet them with the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. God, we heard your word. It is already blessed.
Yes, it is.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
First, I want to give honor to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, all the pastors, ministers, saints, family, and friends. I tried to get my cousin to let me do a solo, but for some reason, she wouldn't let me. You know, I tried, I don't know. So instead, she felt I should read off a piece of paper, so I'm going to try to get So, I want to thank God for blessing our family. And not just our family, but other people with Aunt Frances, because Aunt Frances was, she was just a wonderful lady. We know she was. I was talking to my God sister. I said, Lord, they want me to do the tribute for Aunt Frances. I was like, you know, I'm not a public speaker. I'm in the background. But she was like, that should be easy. Because whenever you saw her, you got what you saw. A loving, caring woman of God. You knew she was saved. You knew she loved the Lord. And she was like, you know, that's easy. And I was like, you're right. She was easy. Easy. Loved her family, her friends, her church members. And she displayed that. She displayed that. Just genuine love people. I was talking to Myrna the other night, and we was talking, and she said that somebody had asked her what was Aunt Frances' favorite scripture. And she said all of them. Now, I don't know if a lot of y'all have tried to read the Bible, Genesis to Revelation. It's not that easy. I mean, it might be easy for y'all, but it's not that easy. But y'all can do like what I do. I listen to it audibly every day. So you can listen to it every day. But reading it is a totally different story. So I was like, that's so amazing. That just let me know that Aunt Frances truly abided by man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. She really displayed that. You know, when I was younger, I used to be like, you know, you come to a funeral and say, well, we're going to have a homegoing celebration. But, you know, you're sitting there hurting. So, you know, it's not a celebration, you know, to you when you don't know Jesus the Christ. It's not a celebration to you. But when you know Jesus the Christ, like Aunt Frances knew Jesus the Christ, this is a celebration.
Yes, it is.
We know she celebrates. I don't know what she's doing. I don't know if she's fixing flowers right now. I don't know if she's playing, singing, but we know she is all right. She's all right. Okay, I know one Sunday, about 4 months ago, me and Penny, we stopped by. And, you know, we didn't call. You know, we just popped up. I don't know about y'all, but Sunday after church, I'm trying to go home, get out these clothes, eat. And I'm not expecting nobody to ring my doorbell, knock at my door, because it's time for me to unwind. But we just popped up in Aunt Frances' house. And the way she looked, excited to see us. You know, she didn't look like you disturbing me, we trying to eat. She genuinely looked like she was so excited to see us. And I was like, you know what? That's how we should be with people. Make them feel excited and welcome. And you know what we can do? We can try to live like Aunt Frances lived and get that relationship with Jesus the Christ. So when she see us again, we can see that excitement in her eyes. So,
amen.
We love our Aunt Frances.
Thank you. Woo. All right.
Come on, please.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Mississippi Mass made a song for my aunt, and my uncle said he will carry you through.
Come on now.
When things get rough, if you call on Jesus, he'll carry you through.
Amen.
All friends are gone, all family's gone. Mm-hmm. If you call on Jesus,
talk about it.
He'll carry you through.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So this morning, I want y'all to understand that we're not supposed to be around here forever. They got a place for us called heaven.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And one of these days, we all going to get there.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to see our people.
Mm-hmm.
I know that heaven is a beautiful place because the Bible tells me so. Where two rivers run through the middle and the streets are paved with gold. Where all of God's children are going to live up there in the city so bright. So bright and fair. I know that heaven is a beautiful place because the Bible tells me so. Where two rivers run through the middle and the streets are paved with gold. Where
thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. I want to stand before you to say thank you to Elder Jackson and thank you to Dr. Fields for sharing this celebration with me on today, to all of the great participants who have participated. Sister Nikki, thank you for that wonderful tribute to Exhorter Jones and this wonderful selection by Brother Glenn Neal. Amen.
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 Thank you,
Father. Amen. Today I will be reading from Isaiah 6, 1 through 4. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
Yes.
And it reads, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord high and exalted, sitting on the throne, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above him were seraphim, each with six wings. With two wings, they covered their faces. With two, they covered their feet. And with two, they were flying. And they were calling to one another. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord Almighty. The whole earth is full of his glory. At the sound of their voices, the door posts and thresholds shook, and the temple was filled with smoke. On today, I would like to speak briefly on the topic, a glimpse of God's glory.
Mm-hmm. All right.
A glimpse of God's glory. Mm-hmm. A glimpse of God's glory. We know that we're gathered today for a solemn day. Some are mourning, some are indifferent, and some have heavy hearts. And some are rejoicing with Sister Frances. Mm-hmm. We know that Sister Frances was a true woman of God. Mm-hmm. In this passage, on this particular day, Isaiah was in the ceremony with the priest, and a vision of Isaiah was able to see the glory of the Lord. The world was at odds. The persons who looked out for them, who cared for them, who helped them to fight the battles, Uzziah was now gone. Mm-hmm. Their guide, their protector was gone. Mm-hmm. Their hope was gone. Mm-hmm. And the people were anxious and concerned about what they will do next. And during these times, what did Isaiah do? He went to the temple, taking his fears, his anxieties, and his concerns to the sanctuary. This is where Isaiah, who had walked with God and had grown more sensitive to the spiritual and eternal values, he began to treasure his relationship with God more than his religion. In that moment, Isaiah was alone with God, and and the earthly scene faded, and there was the sound of singing from the voices of the angels singing, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord, and the earth is full of his glory." And in that moment, we find that Isaiah was experiencing the power and the presence of God. And on this day, Isaiah was able to see beyond the material and the physical realm and witness and commune with God. And in our lives, we too must get to that place in God that we see beyond the physical and understand what God is calling us to do spiritually. Jesus said in John 11:40, he says, "Did I not tell you that if you believed that you will see the glory of God?" This lets us know that anyone who accepts Jesus, accept the Lord, the Savior, can have access to God's glory. What will that require of us? Is to see the glimpse of God's glory, to accept Jesus Christ, our Savior. The pastor, John Piper, says this: God's glory is the source and the sum of all full of lasting joy. There is something that comes over us that moves us and touches us when we get to experience the presence of God, when God's glory is among us. We get the glimpse of God's glory when we feel his touch. We get the glimpse of God's glory when we feel his spirit, when God is directing us to move in his path. We get to feel God's glory of his presence, just like when he whispered to Elijah the prophet when he was hiding in a cage, fearing for his life. God's glory showed up as a cloud by day and fire by night to travel with the Israelites as they made their journey to the promised land. We can experience and have witnessed
God's glory. And on today, as we know with our woman of God, exhorter Jones, we know that this songbird, amen, that can make the walls tremble in the church, could attest to the lyrics of the song, I Am a Living Testimony. Because there were times that the Lord spared her life so that she can live a little while longer as to witness to what God was able for her to do. She was able to get a glimpse of God's glory, of God's power, to be in the presence of God, to experience God, to see the change and the transformations come before us, and to experience the trials and the tribulations. She is the living testimony. I believe that Sister Jones had impacted many who she had come across through her preaching, through her undergirding, through her teaching, through her love. I know at Bethel AME Church, every Sunday morning, she would get up and teach Sunday school. She would teach a Bible study. And one thing about Exhorter Jones in her teachings, you can definitely tell that she searched God's word through her heart. She had labored over the word. When you go to her house, she would have the Bibles all over the kitchen table with many references. As she began to prepare to exemplify the presence of God's glory under the anointing of God. We will always cherish those provoking thoughts and conversations by Exhorter Jones to test our knowledge and our understanding through her wisdom. She used to always call everybody baby, honey, daughter, sugar, amen. I'm just so glad that Sister Bonnie and Sister Avis was able to let us share these moments with her. She made an imprint of our in our lives on this spiritual journey that we'll never forget. In her preachment, she was preparing us for God's glory when she preached one Sunday morning Psalm 30 and 5 when she said, we've been made endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I believe that through her great accomplishments in life, in her great works of being an exhorter, a preacher, a teacher, missionary, a pastor's aide, that God was shining his light through her so that his glory can be magnified. I believe that she chose to love a little bit stronger and to plant her feet on God's solid rock that we stand on. 2 weeks ago, I believe that Exhorter Jones chose to go a little higher in her worship. I believe she chose the choice to have peace that surpasses our human understanding. When she had a little talk with the Dr. Jesus and knowing that everything was going to be all right, and that she was glad about it. I believe that during this time that the chains were breaking off some things that had her bound so that the joy couldn't be completed and that her soul would be ready to meet the Lord on this next train to glory. I want to say that we must allow God's presence to change and to prepare us to come to an understanding as the words in Paul in Romans 8:18 where Paul says, I reckon.
Come on.
All right now.
He said, I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory, that shall be revealed to us. God's glory calls us to go to higher places in the Lord. Isaiah has been called to commission to the higher place in God. It says that I saw God, I saw the Lord, and the train of his robe filled the temple. But on Friday, on this past Friday, Sister Frances was not the presence in the presence of God, but she was on that glory train that came for her to begin to arrive to be with the Lord. Some of us will believe that she is resting. Others will say that she is deep in a deep sleep. But Jesus told the thief and said that beside him on the cross,
this day you will meet me in paradise.
And I don't believe that Jesus would lie.
And in this moment, Exhorter
Jones was alone with God, and the earthly scene had faded, and there was the sound of the glory train, where the voices of the angels were singing, holy, holy, holy is the Lord, who we are basking in God's glory. When the glory train arrived, Sister Jones' name was called. Her ticket was stamped, and she entered in a place where every day is going to be like Sunday. She entered the place where times has now become timelessness, where the glory of the Lord shines, and the sun shines every single day, where all the pain and the fear is gone, where there's no more dying, there's no more headaches, there's no more crying, there's no more worrying. Every day is going to be a celebration of worship over yonder. I said over yonder, beyond the sky, where we too have everlasting life. And now, instead of Sister Frances Exhorter Jones being in the gospel choir, she's singing in God's heavenly choir. She saw a glimpse of the Lord. She saw a glimpse of God's glory that surpasses, that supersedes any joy, that supersedes any happiness, and any love that she can witness on earth on this side. And may we too be prepared when our name is called to ride on the train to glory. And may we too walk the life of Sister Jones and have our name called with our ticket stamped. A glimpse of God's glory. A glimpse of God's glory.
Amen.
A glimpse of God's glory.
Amen. Amen.
We know that Sister Frances lived an awesome life. 82, 83 years old. What a wonderful life that is. And we thank God that she has impacted all of us. At this time, we are going to do our committal rites at this time, and our benediction. Amen.
Amen.
For as it has pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our deceased sister, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Looking through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth, and the sea shall give up their dead and corruptible bodies, of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his glorious body, according to the mighty workings whereby he is able to subdue all things unto him. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And we will go ahead and prepare for our benediction before we ask the funeral directors to come forth. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
yes,
and the love of God,
mm-hmm,
and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. On behalf of the family, we'd like to take this opportunity to thank Pastor Wright, Dr. Field, Pastor Jackson, mm-hmm, to Brother Glenn, Deacon Nikki, to all of you that have come out today to show your love and support to this family which I also am proud to be, mm-hmm, a member of.
Oh, yeah.
And we just want to thank each and every one of you for coming out, show your love and support, mm-hmm, and every act of kindness that's been shown to the family. They truly want to say thank you so very, very much. Mm-hmm. But they do ask that you would continue to pray for them, that they would need, mm-hmm, your prayers in the upcoming weeks and months. And to the family, thank you for allowing us to serve you. And if there's anything we can do, our service does not end today. If you need us for anything, please feel free to call upon us. At this time, we will consider the homegoing of our beloved Frances Mae Johnson Jones complete. May her soul be at rest in peace. And God be with us all, and may we all go in peace. And thank you again for coming. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.